Microphone activated.
Well, just in time, I guess. Almost missed start the game. Back to us, Huns versus Huns Mentalist. This was Mentalist home map, Double Arabia. This is going to be an interesting map. Very crazy game. I mean, Double Arabia is always pretty intense. Requires a lot of micro. Looks like Baptiste found some sheep on both TCs. Building a mill on one of them early on. Mentalist just using the sheep under TC. Population the same, 10 for each. Obviously, start with 3 bills under each TC. If you can pump from 2 TCs, you'll have an advantage. Both of them have loom. Mentalist going to add the first lumber camp, it looks like. Nope. Mentalist also adding a mill. I think they have to take straggler tree CCs. Looks like Batty has 47 woods. 22 for Mentalist. Luring the first boar now. For one of his TCs. Adding a villager to wood as well. I'd imagine Mentalist has a build prepared because this is his home map. Batty luring in the first boar as well. Mentalist luring in the second boar now. I'm not sure if Batty's going to go for his second boar just yet. Population one ahead for Mentalist, but one of his vills was idle for a little bit, according to the spec overlay. There is a lot to do. You have to watch 2 TCs. You have to micro 2 scouts. It's a lot of work playing Double Arabia. This deer must have run through Batty's TC. If he notices it, that would be a nice catch. Easy free deer, but I don't think he has. Same number of bills. As Batty must have scouted more of the map. So Mentalist has just lured 2 boars. Batty is going for the second boar now. 1 boar under each TC for both. Mentalist is going for the second boar under the bottom TC. No wonder they will start adding lumber camps soon, I think. Yep, Mentalist just added his. He has 100 wood. He's going to send the vills over. Batty doing the same. Needs to use these vills under his TC. Going to send them on food. Probably going to lure the second boar soon. He does have a lot of deer. Double deer patch, 2 sets of 3. Seeing each other's scouts. Mentalist is going to group his scouts together now. Could catch out Batty's scout. No, it's not going to. Some nice deer nets in the mill from Mentalist there. Putting a lot of vills on wood. Is Batty actually going to try and lure deer? He's surely not. Okay. Accidentally taking sheep a bit far from the TC without realising it. He's got another boar being eaten here. So Mentalist has taken 3 of his 4 boars. And Batty has taken only 2 of them. Ah, he's taking the third one now. And the fourth, so Batty will have taken all 4 boars. Mentalist will only have taken 3. He hasn't quite scouted his own fourth boar yet. They're the same population. Oh, garrison the vill, Batty. Yep, there we go. I think being 1 boar ahead is going to help Batty a lot. Mentalist is going to run into TC. You should see the straggler tree. He can see TC. Yep, he's not going to run into it. Batty going with 2 scouts now. Batty up to the feudal age, 36 population. I don't know if he's going to FC off of this or if he's going for an earlier flush. Mentalist will also go to feudal age soon as well. Yep, almost the same. Mentalist 1 villager ahead as it stands. Mentalist adding some farms as well, built a second mill. Batty going to mill the deer instead of the second berry patch, adding a second lumber camp. Going to take the deer with the villagers for Mentalist. Batty 4 on gold. Mentalist is not adding any to gold yet. Maybe he's going for scouts. I'm really not sure what either player is doing. I'm very not aware with Double Arabia builds. It's a very Unique map. I think there's a map with the three TC stars. Well, it's disgusting. Batsy's probably going to try and raid with the scouts when he hits Fuelage. Like, starting with two scouts is nice. A Barrett's coming up for Mentalist. Barrett's coming up for back T. Map's quite open for both players. It would be kind of hard to wall off. I know it's quite nice thing to wall off one TC and have one TC open for your military. It looks like it is going to be an FC from Bat. He's going to drop a stable on the blacksmith and go to the castle age. Mentalist has a lot less food. Obviously, that minus one boar really beginning to show. Killing one villager with the two scouts. Nice snipe, but he did lose a scout for it. Oh, he's found Mentalist second to TC. So Mentalist is doing just scouts. He's doing horse collar and double bit, so he's going full flush. Whereas back T is adding the blacksmith and then he'll go to the castle age. Probably add some spearmen. Nope, not even spearmen. Adding a single scout. Then he's going to click up, I think. Really looks like he wants to FC. Yep, back T is FCing, 13 minute castle age. Mentalist is going for a full flush, which could be quite dangerous. Bat-T has zero spearmen, he only has two scouts of his own. If he's, you know, there's four scouts from Mentalist already, they could do a lot of damage. Especially to all these foodvilles from Bat-T and the woodvilles. Nice micro, he's going to snipe two vills there, I think. It's definitely at least one. Bat-T's going to wall in the wood line now, send the vills back. Yep, did lose two vills. Has walled his woodline though, the berries walling in as well. Or somewhat, adding a couple of farms. He will do two stable knights at least, I think, back T. He hasn't done double bit axe or husbandry. Horse collar yet, I think. Has quite a lot of resources. Yep, there's the second stable. Hasn't built a second lumber camp, I think he will soon. He used to use this villager. Yeah, it's getting town watch. Let's see if Mentalist did enough damage. He is 10 vills ahead at minute 13, which is something. Obviously, Bat-T's idled a bit. He's minus 2 vills. A wheelbarrow for Bat-T. Second TC up. The thing is, if he can raid a lot, then he can make it up really easily with knights. Because obviously, Mentalist is going up in a couple of minutes. This is going to hurt though, all these scouts. Going to lose another villager, not quite. May lose a couple of vills on these on the gold. He's going to make the knights and send them straight there. He's going to send the vills back. Going to lose at least one, possibly two. Yeah, Bat-T minus another two vills. So Bat-T's lost over five vills at minute 14. That's quite bad for him. Nice micro sending the scout away. He's going to fight the vills now and let another vill dead. Those scouts did some very good damage to Bat-T, I think. But it is double stable knights now, so let's see if he can defend himself. Let's see if Bat-T can do the damage back. Bat-T's gone inside the stone walls on one of the TCs. With knights, he's going to do a lot of damage. He's going to kill these two vills as they are stuck. He needs to try and stop Mentalist walling, but I don't think he's noticed yet. He hasn't seen yet. He's going straight for the gold. Mentalist is walling the gold, however, and it is fully walled now. So the gold is safe for Mentalist. He's still got two scouts alive trying to raid. But he's still on two TCs. He's still 10 vills behind. He's overtaken his score, but Mentalist is up to the castle age. He has more upgrades. The four knights coming in on the berries, but they won't be able to do too much. However, Actually, he's got forging. I guess he got forging because it applies to the knights and spearmen rather than getting a, you know, plus one spearman defense upgrade. Or, you know, the knight defense upgrade. So I think this was a good decision for Mentalist. As long as Bat-T doesn't kill this whole woodline, then Mentalist may have some problems. But as it stands, he's still 10 villagers ahead. He will have less knights though. Bat-T's gonna fight this. He's gonna lose two knights maybe. He's gonna lose all his knights. Strong spearman. Yeah, I think that's really bad. Bati losing all his knights and doing zero damage. Trying to fight those spearmen with forging. Getting scale barding armor now. Probably gonna add a TC soon for Bati. He didn't wall any of the sides. If he walled one of his sides off, maybe we would have been alright, but as it stands, he's actually the villager deficit's not as much. But he's losing so many knights to these spearmen. Like, that's a lot of spearmen though. He's actually forcing Mensis to invest a lot, but he can't afford to lose more knights. He really needs to make advantage of the fact that he got to Castle Age at minute 13. Really try and push with the knights and just, I mean, look at the amount of spearmen. You can't push that. GB. Pikeman. Crikey. That's defensive. Stonewalled one side. He's got pikemen. Is it double barracks, pikemen? No, it's just single barracks. He's just spamming them. Spamming. Market for mentalist. I'm not sure what for. Maybe he wants to sell some wood. He has a lot of wood. Both are still on 2 TCs. A double stable knights, +1/+1 for mentalist, +1 attack for Bati. I mean, +1 defense, sorry. Gonna try and snipe a villager or two on the wood line. I don't think he will be able to. Nope, he sniped one. Needs to kill the pikeman. Pikeman killing two knights again. Just Bati losing knight after knight to pikeman. Knights can, it should kill the pikeman 1v1, or maybe not, nope. Getting raided a little bit at home, but he's not getting raided at home as much now, he is adding the third town centre. He needs to catch up in the Ville, can he? He's idling Mentalist a lot more though. I think Mentalist had a lot more idle time than Bati. Especially on this wood line. But he does have 600 woods, he doesn't have enough farms though. Mentalist is 8 population ahead, they're probably going to fight on this hill, but obviously Mentalist has more upgrades and more knights. Bloodlines come up for Mentalist, a monastery now to add some monks. Bati going to mass back at home. Both on the limit of resources. Similar populations though, and it's just going to turn into big fights now. Still pretty close. That stone wall really helping Mentalist, adding a TC on top of that hill. I think if Bati goes with all the knights, Mentalist will have some problems. He's going to wall, but the knights are going to get in. I think Bati is getting some more upgrades. He does need more upgrades to fight though, I think. It's bloodline +1/+1 versus just +1 defense with monks and pikemen. Yeah, Bati's going to lose this so hard if he fights this. I don't know why he's fighting this. He's just going to waste his whole army and there's just no point. Yeah, I think he killed himself then. Like, he had a good number of knights and he could have been alright, but he just walked in for like no reason. I mean, I know that I've got spec thingy, but all you have to do is just click a knight and you can see the upgrades it has. So now he's on the back foot. He's only 4 vills behind though. At least he's catching up in eco, but he can't afford to get behind an army either and get raided. Gonna convert one knight, then lose a monk, so a monk for a knight. In fact, he will still lose this engagement just because of the number of upgrades. He'll win under the TC though. Gonna lose a knight to a monk. Nope, not quite. In fact, he hasn't walled anything, whereas Mentalist has walled a lot of the map, which is helping him. This whole left right side is now pretty much safe. He's only gonna focus on the other side. In fact, he's still focusing on both. Mentalist dropping the 4th TC. Bati's still only on the 3. Again, Bati trying to go up, but I really don't think he should. He doesn't have the upgrades. He's getting bloodlines, getting forging and forward siege workshop, chain barding armor coming up for Mentalist. Mentalist wants to push in Castle Age. Maybe adding a third stable soon, I'm not sure. 117 pop to 96. So he's ahead in vills by 4, but he's ahead in army by quite a bit if you look at the. But you see Bati's at least seen this, he will react to it, hopefully he'll get +2, Bati getting Bowsaw. It's 18 cavalry to 16, so a similar number of knights. But I think the chain barding armor will make the difference. Bati needs to be careful of this, he shouldn't. Needs to garrison in TC, where are you going? What's he doing? Not sure what Batsy's doing. Why doesn't he just kill all the knights and then go counter raid? I guess he is planning to do that, he just didn't think he needed as many, maybe. Mentalist gonna try and raid everywhere. There's a siege workshop coming up for Bat-T now at home. Maybe he saw Mentalist's siege workshop. Mentalist is on the brink of food. It seems to be a real problem. Adding another barracks, maybe you're gonna do, yeah, scale mail. He's gonna go full pikemen, monks, rams, and just do full castle push. This was Mentalist's home map after all, remember? Bat-T adding a monastery, the rams coming in. I think this is going to be a fast GG, just seeing the way that Bat-T's playing this. I don't think he's going to survive the castle push. He's behind in Vils by 20. He's behind in Vils, he's behind in upgrades, and he's being pushed at the front. I mean, if he kills the push, then yeah, I think he's got a good chance, but I think he's going to struggle. Coming with his own knights, getting the plus 2 defense as well. Vils going down to the knights. 3 monks for Mentalist. If he converts 3 knights, it will be worth it, because he'll convert the knights, and the knights go to kill the monks, and the pikemen come in from behind and kill off all the rest of the knights anyway, so you don't... So it's kind of a better trade, even though monks are technically more expensive. Bat-T calling the GG. Very, very aggressive play from Bat-T there. 53 units killed to 42. More resources for Mentalist. 2,000 more food, 4,000 more wood. He actually got stone as well. He got less gold, but that didn't matter in the end. He still had more army. Difference in times. The early scouts really did some good damage, and he defended at home well. Didn't lose many vills. And yeah, 175 vill count. Very well played. That's 2-2. This is game 5. Is it game 5 the set map? Bat-T's home map is Regicide Fortress. Yeah, okay, I wasn't muted. Scared for a second. Good game so far.
Microphone muted. Microphone activated.
So hot here. I'm boiling. Like 20 degrees. I'm dying. Oh, so game 5 is back to your home map. Richard's Regicide Fortress. Probably going to be Mayhem War. Every Regicide Fortress I've seen so far has been a Mayhem War. counting down, so should be done soon. Seems like a lot of NAB's members are picking Nomad. One's playing Ryu right now and he's picked Nomad. I feel like he's winning as well. Good luck to him if he beats Ryu. Cavs and Skirms, Persia vs. Right, so yeah, Regicide Fortress, Mayhem War. Looking at the maps, any of the maps bugged? Nope, fine, good. No dodgy house spawn, no gold spawn. Everything looks good. Oh, looks like Bacti's already deleted a gate, I'm not sure what that's about. Going very... Oh, he's building a lumber... Ah, I wanted a lumber camp there. Two lumber camps? Oh, interesting. Maybe he wants maximum efficiency in the other... resources to be able to make two of them. See a very early ball off from Mentalist getting the ball with his eagle. Elite Garrison Eagle and TC. Obviously there's no gold and therefore we cannot get Loom early on. Both walls are Bat-T. Bat-T luring the first ball as well with his eagle. Castle in front of the balls makes it kind of hard to lame them. He'll garrison the villas, so send them out. Going to scout with the king. Mentalist bringing in the second ball. Yeah, he'll go scouting with his king as well. I don't know if Bat-T will get the second ball just as soon, or whether he'll go around the front, scout a bit, then go back and get it. No, so he's going back to get it. Both scouting with their kings. Neither's lost a bill, both got balls under the TC. Both going to go for very fast feudal age times. Four vills and wood for Bat-T with two lumber camps. Three vills and wood for Mentalist with one lumber camp, so slight difference in build there. Mill to mill, three vills in the mill for Bat-T, whereas there are four vills on the mill for Mentalist. So three vills versus four. So the only difference really is that Mentalist has one less vill on wood, one more on berries, and Bat-T has one more on wood. Luring the second ball now, so he's luring the second ball a bit later. Probably doesn't matter that much. I mean, if you look at the efficiency, Mentalist is going to have them both under the TC. Rotting away, whereas Bat-T's going to use up one of them before using the second one, pretty much. Adding two vills to gold. Where's the resources tab? There we go, 535 food for Bat-T, 473 for Mentalist. They're both going to go to Feudal Age very soon. Actually, he's adding a couple more villagers, putting three on gold so far. Three on gold for Bat-T, two. Four vills on wood now for Mentalist, still four vills on wood for Bat-T, three vills on berries. Bat-T's garrison eagle and TC to heal it, whereas Mentalist is still scouting the map. Clicked up at exactly the same time with the same population. Don't really need to check to know it's going to be the same. 21 vills, 23 pop obviously because of the king and the eagle. The eagle finds the king, it doesn't matter, the king can run faster, so it's unlikely to die to the eagle. I think Mentalist has scouted a bit more of the map, it looks like. Yep, but neither player has found each other as of yet, but they will soon. They were both fast castle. Bat-T has 400 wood. Mentalist also has 500 wood. Only 4 vills on wood at the moment. Adding a couple more farms, gonna send this vill to berries probably. Maybe add another farm. Don't want to have any idols, nope. Sending it to... Oh. Here. Shorts over there. Using one vill to take stone so we can make more TCs. Batsy using three vills to do the same thing. Not adding mining camps, just sending the vills. The king can see the vills from Entelis going outside. Not that it can really do anything about it. There is a wolf there, so Mentis has to be careful. Maybe he knows there's a wolf there. Building a market. Blacksmith outside his base. He's going to try and wolf this side. Get this wood, this gold, this stone. Market and blacksmith for Bacti too. He needs to be careful. Actually, the eagle's half health. And his eagle is here at full health. So he doesn't really have to worry. He could be delayed a little bit. But the chance of his vill dying is pretty low. Oh, no loom. I forgot about that. No loom. The vill will... not perish. Nice. The eagle was not able to kill the loom without the loom without vill, the vill without loom. 4 HP. The Mentalist Eagle. He doesn't want to lose the eagle, really. I think he'll save it, though. He'll just send it back to his base. Risky King Scouting. Batty going to the castage slightly faster. Mentalist will add one extra villager, maybe. Nope. Okay, so I think Bacti's build was slightly more refined. He's gone up a bit faster. He's also doing double bit axe.
Shot it.
Oh, he's using the king to block the eagle. So novel, but didn't quite work. It would have been amazing if it had worked. It would have also been worse if it got trapped in Mentalist's space. Mentalist trying to not lose the vills of the wolf in the castle. Horse collar coming up for Bacti, double bitax coming up for the Mentalist, 4 vills on gold for Bacti, 2, 6, 8 vills on wood for Bacti. Also he'll have 200 stone, so he can make another TC. Mentalist is just using one villager, he should have 200 stone by the time that he needs it. He doesn't have quite 200, he's using stone to build tiles as well. Eagle taking a little bit of damage from the towers, but the 6 is too much. About it. Both going to do plumed archers, TCs, and castle. Probably play the imp war, rams, trebs, plumes, that kind of thing. I'd be very surprised if one of them tried to play the castle war, because the thing is, in this map, it's so easy to boom to imp. By the time you've really put castle pressure on, they're just going to go up and beat you with the superior upgrades. That's generally what happens in this map. We see there's going to be an outside castle in the wood here for Bacti to stop any potential raiding. Also, it's pretty hard to put, you know, you don't put TC there. So good TC for Bacti. Mentis is going to go up now as well, getting fletching, adding plumed archers. Going to send them out there with the eagle. The eagle has +3 attack, but it's very low HP still. He's going to chase up the plumed archer. I don't think he'll be able to kill it. He'll try fletching and bowsaw coming up for both players. Both players adding plumed archers. Same. Is there a second TC? Mentis adding second TC here. That's probably why I walled off the front. The protection, bit of micro, archers with similar, yep, it looks like a Bacti's archer took one more hit. We see a second eagle coming out just to act as a meat shield. Oh, Bacti going forward with the archers, needs to be careful. Oh, Bacti's outnumbered a bit. He will kill this one plume. He's going to kill Mentalist's eagle. His eagle, own eagle, will also go down. Oh, he didn't kill Mentalist. Oh, he killed Mentalist's first eagle, not the second one. So Bacti's on 2 TCs, he's 2 vills ahead. Mentalist is just getting up the second TC now. Bacti used more vills to build the first one, so I guess he got it up. He used 3 vills instead of 2. You see the eagle going from Mentalist to scout the map. Bacti's also. They both scouted most of the map by this point. You can see it's more just bits of holes. Actually, Bacti scouted more, you can see more of Mentalist's base than Mentalist can see of his base. 37 pot to 39, very similar. Horse collar coming up for Mentalist now, starting to add some farms. Bacti adding a 3rd TC on the gold. Mentalist is not yet adding a 3rd TC, he will be before too long. But again, I think because this is Bacti's home map, his build is slightly more refined. Mentalist is obviously like completely, he understands the map as well and how to macro, but I think Bacti's got it. Oh, gotta be careful. Bacti, oh dear, he's not microing at all. Doing a loom, losing 2 vills. If I look at the army count, I think Mentalist is a bit ahead on plumes. 3 kills to 1, 12 plumes to 10. So it's, Bacti doesn't want to make too many bad engagements like that. He wasn't patrolling, he wasn't looking. I don't think either players, yep, Mentis wants Wolf left side of the map, just to make sure his base is completely protected. He's still sending Vils to this stone without a mining camp. I don't really like that. It's quite inefficient. Especially after you've stopped. Ah, that's some nice micro from Bat-T, sending the first plume away. Needs to be careful not to have the plumes coming out get trapped though. I think he's going to try and trap Mentalist's army in his side of the map and then just hunt them down. And you see he's actually built a palisade wall here just to keep the Vils safe. Obviously, I don't think he had any. Yep, zero stone. Needs to move the Vil back, which he has done. Oh, there is a hole. There's a hole. This is why I like grid mod, because it stops you from things like this happening. He's going to lose 1 Vil, 2 Vil, 3 Vil, 4 Vil. 4, 5. 5 Vils. Rip. I mean, the thing is, Mentalist is going to... Don't let Mentalist get out, please. You have to kill his army now. But he lost so many Vils that, like, Mentalist is only 2 Vils ahead, though, to be fair. After all that, it's just I really don't want to see the army escape. Like, Bat-T has to win this quite decisively. Both microing hard on this hill. I mean, obviously, his tower's fighting, but it's only firing one arrow. Don't let Mentalist get out, please. That's not a thing that's allowed to happen. Obviously, Bat-T can send more plumes back up from behind. Because he needs to be able to raid Mentalist as well, because he lost so many Vils because of that hole. Back to getting gold mining. Mentalist is adding the 3rd TC now, so Mentalist is still 4 Vils ahead. He's added the 3rd TC a lot later, but because of that hole, he's actually 4 Vils ahead, even though he's lost his army. And it's quite hard to raid him. I mean, he has placed foundations for Stonewall. Okay, he's going to build it now. But Back to can't really raid anywhere. There's nowhere to raid Mentalist from. I mean, Back to could have... Oh, I guess that was the only wood he could really realistically take, this wood. Just this hole, and he's not even doing anything about it yet. Actually, he is now. He's gonna... No. Yes, no, maybe. You have to be very careful. Very, very, very careful with holes like that. Both in wheelbarrow, Bodkin Arrow up for back tee. I think he's just gonna get out boomed at this rate. I mean, he's only 2 Vils behind, but I don't know. Getting Bodkin, and it just depends, can he do anything with it? I mean, he can hit this wood line just about, but I think that's all he can hit. The map for Mentalist is generally nicer. Safe for gold, safe for wood, safe for stone. Well, I guess the gold and stone for Bat-T is really safe as well, it's just his wood's a bit exposed at the front. And Mentalist is now full of the map, he's adding University, getting Ballistics. I mean, a Bodkin, sorry. Mentalist coming back. 1 Vil, 2 Vil. Oh, you got 2 Vils. Now they have the same village account, so I guess it's about even. Mentalist has to be careful, obviously Bat-T's now walled this, so he's less susceptible to raiding. Both on a similar population, Bat-T 2 ahead. It looks like the army's about the same, so Mentalist is still caught up. Bat-T needs to send the Vils back, I don't know if he's noticed. He has, he's going to lose one villager again. And he built the house next to the lumber camp, that's a bit annoying. But it's just losing these Vils here and there. He's going to try and kill the army. And since I think he's killed yet another Vil, he needs to move from under the TC. Ballistics coming up for Mentalist, but he is not focusing on that yet. Come in. Microphone muted. Yeah. So I didn't really miss much. They're gonna fight a bit. Looks like Bat-T has a lot more now. Oh, not that many more. Well, it's gonna be a lot many more. Yeah, he's. Even without ballistics, he just didn't need it. He's getting ballistics now himself. But he's got over double the plumed archers. Mentalist. He's now ahead in population. He's still 4 Vils ahead than Mentalist. Even though he, I think they lost a similar amount actually. And because he had 3 CCs for longer, he was able to make up for it. He can can actually raid this woodline at the front as well, a little bit, it looks like. Bacti's housed at 100 population, Mentalist knows that Doons are coming, sent the villas back, adding Siege Workshop, going to add some mangonels, it looks like. Yep, mangonels, but ballistics up for Bacti as well. And he's gonna 3 TC boon to Imp. Not sure where all these stone villas are going, maybe just take the forward stone. Bacti, oh no, he's gonna build a second castle, but where? Where is he going to build the second castle?
How's she game?
Shot it. Now they're going to fight. Obviously, ballistics are both a mangonel there, though, for Mentalist. Gotta be careful of that. Right, he's still with the number advantage. Oh! Got hit a bit. He's gonna build the castle in front of his goals. Best place to protect it, building a defensive siege workshop of his own. Bacti's housed again. So the other games it was Mentalist getting housed, that's Bacti. Mentalist is being more careful of it this time. Bacti up to the Imperial Age. I didn't notice his resources, but Mentalist is a bit far off. Going Imp, which I think is going to hurt him a lot, because Bacti going Imp first, so I'll just get Bracer and Chemistry and Trebs. And then Mentalist is going to have some problems. Bacti trying to raid, going to lose a couple of these plumes. Mentalist trying to take that hill, but Bacti looks like he wants to push from the left hand side of the map, which makes much more sense. Doesn't want to push the hill. Mentalist is also building castles, so Mentalist is defending the right side of the map, whereas Bacti wants to push left side, he's going to kill one more vill. Mentalist also up to the Imperial Age, 1 minute later, Bacti getting handcart, killing two more villagers. Villager difference is about the same, but Bacti is still six plumes ahead, not too many. It is two castles versus one, so the plume difference will increase, padded archer armor, stone mining. Going to go back and raid the wood yet again. These plumes from Mentalist can't really do much. This castle protects pretty much everything. This has all been house walled off. You can trap the plumes from Bacti, losing yet another villager. 126, 116 population. Will the mangonel make the difference? Let's see. Troll in. Bacti going to have to GB because of the mangonel fire. Got his own mangonel at home, sending his own other plumes to go and help. He doesn't want to lose all these plumes before getting in, even though he is at this rate. He just wants to try and kill as many as possible. That's kind of, that was a nice trap for Mentalist. I think Bacti wasn't expecting that. Getting Bracer. That. Of Archer Armor coming up from Mentalist, Chemistry. So Bacti's lost a number advantage, he's gonna have to be quite clever now. Mentalist using Attack Ground. Using Attack Ground again, not working. Getting off three shots, but losing the mangonel to the plumes. A third castle up for Bacti. Only two castles up for Mentalist. I mean, Bacti can just fight under the castle with his superior upgrades. Now he's got his plumes together, he'll just patrol in again. Let them rip. Mentalist having to delete tile in the wall to send his plumes back. Trebuchet out. Two trebs out for Bacti, so I think the trebs, he'll get them a lot faster, obviously three castles versus two. I think Mentalist is doing rams instead. Not sure yet. So Mentalist is ahead in population at the moment. He's ahead in vills, but he must have more army. He does indeed. Mentalist has more army than Bacti. Trebs coming out for both players. Going to be some big fights here. Bacti going to move his trebuchet back, just going for the tower first. Usually keep kings in one of the towers. This is where Bacti's king is. Mentalist is keeping the king in the castle, which I've not seen Red Side Fortress players do. They really don't like to do that. It's very risky. It's very, very risky being asshole. From what I've heard. I'm not sure where Bati's army is going. He's leaving the three trebuchets exposed at the front alone. He's going to go back now to deal with it. Oh! Mangonel shot, but it's going to go down to the plumes if he's not careful. There's a battering ram. Bati needs to think about it. He's going to go for the Mangonel. No, he's going for the plumes. Move back the trebuchets. Might lose one. Nope, he's going to make it out alive. Needs to be careful though, don't want to waste his plumed archers. They have the same upgrades. But elite coming up for Bati as well. That 1,000 wood, 500 upgrade, very expensive. Shot it. He must be adding, I think Bati's going to add some rams soon. Because if he doesn't add rams, my microphone was a bit far away, I moved it closer. If you don't get rams in Mayan's War, you pretty much die. Because rams is really strong in Mayan Wars. See, just having one Mangonel and three rams is keeping Bati at bay. Well, the Mangonel not so much, it's going to die, but those rams. I wonder if Bati's going down the Onager route, I'd be surprised. I'm going to try and block the rams with plumes. The thing is, the amount of plumes and things that Bati's losing is much more than the cost of a ram. Bati with the elite plumed archers. He will defend this trebuchet, actually. Oh, just. But also, Menselis can't really fight this now because elite plumes are much, much stronger. And Bati has a plus 4 defense. Oh no, they both have elite. My mistake. One treb going down for Bati though. Three castles up for Menselis now. He's going to have to relocate the king very soon. Bati trying to kill a trebuchet of plumes. He should probably GB. He's going to lose more than it's worth at this rate. Because he's just going to lose so many plumed archers trying to kill it and then it's going to get repaired. That like he's lost 10, 15 plumes? I don't know, 6, 7, whatever, but he's just focused on protecting his own trebuchets at this rate. He may lose the castle though, he doesn't want to lose the castle. But at the same time he's going to kill Mentalist's castle. Which I think is more important. Oh, the king, do not send. What's he doing with the- oh my gosh. He almost sent it straight into the plums of Bati. Bati needs to be careful, he's going to lose this fight badly, like really, really badly. He's not patrolling at all or anything. He has to GB, I don't know why he's not GBing. There's more rams. Bati is being way too stubborn not adding rams, and he's just not going back. He can't fight these battles much longer, and if he doesn't make a third castle soon, he's going to be at a massive disadvantage. He is adding capped rams though as well. He is ahead in population of 160 to 135. He's made a lot more vills than Mentalist. So let's see how it goes. I think Mentalist is playing as well. Like the early rams really helped him a lot. He did lose his castle in the end, but he also killed the castle of Bati, and the rams have been a massive meat shield. So I think that was a really smart move. Because obviously he knew his opponent got up first, so he couldn't try and out-treb him in the treb war, so just add some rams because it's a Mayan war. Putting the king in the back castle instead. Trying to raid with a few plumes, so Bati wants to do the same. Bati, I don't know where he's going. I'm surprised he isn't still just trying to push this left side, because he could push through the whole Mentalist base. These castles only protect the golden wood at the side. If he put a hole in Mentalist base, then it wouldn't really matter. He's actually going back to the left-hand side now with his capped rams. His trebs, siege ram upgrading for Bati. This is going to be big. I was just looking for the resources. Going to take the gold in the right hand side of the map as well. Bati generally has more map control in my opinion. Raidville Siege Workshop here. So it looks like they are both migrating to pushing the right hand side instead. It's just going to be a little ram war on the left. Eagle's going to fight. He can kill it with Vils if he fights, if he sees it that is. This is going to be big. I think Bati has more rams now. Not noticing the eagle yet. He's winning on the left-hand side as well. Siege Ram Thundering Heavy Plow and Two Man Saw. And Siege Ram also coming up from Mentalist. Obviously, Mentalist can't really fight this battle. Now, he's the one on the back foot with the inferior upgrades and inferior amount of rams. This Eagle's just doing so much harassment. He's just sending a few plumes there to go and finish off the rest of the Vills. So Batsy's going to try and push with the Trebs now, kill the castle. He's got three Siege Rams, he's going to wait till he has more until he pushes two man sword up for Batsy, putting the plumes in front of the Trebs to protect them from the Siege Ram. There's a lot more rams for Batsy. If he patrols in now, he could do some good damage, I think. Mental is just trying to Treb Batsy's Trebs. Batsy needs to repair his Trebs before they go down to Mentalist's Trebs. Mentalist has more rounds. Masonry for Bacti. I think this hill is helping Mentalist a lot as well. Bacti's coming with the rams on the castle. If he kills the castle, this will be very good for Bacti, but he does need to be very careful. He should be repairing the Trebs. He's going to lose it now for sure. Oh my gosh, it missed. The rams aren't being dealt with. And now the Vills are attacking the rams instead of repairing the castle, which is going to take more damage. Looking at the ram war, it looks like oh, the castle is down for Mentalist. So Mentalist is down to one castle now. So it's one castle versus two. Pretty bad situation for Mentalist. You don't want to be like this. He has killed the gold Vills and he can do some raiding with these plumes at the back. But I don't think it'll be enough. One castle versus three. Oh no, he has got two castles, sorry. He's got two castles on that hill. Batsy's actually added the third as well. No, yep. So three castles for each. Obviously, the more siege rounds for Mentalist, so Batsy has to be careful now. Going to move his last Treb back. Probably going to move his plumes back as well and remass rams. Going to try and take this hill on the left with these plumes. If he does get that hill, it'll be really, really good for Batsy. Gonna try and push again now, patrolling in. He's got his rams ready. Squires? Is he actually doing Elite Eagle Warriors as well? He may be. Ah, here are the plumes for Mentalist. Going to raid the gold. I hope Batsy notices. He didn't notice when the other gold was raided. He is taking extra star on the map as well. He has got a lot more rams than Mentalist. So he is 200 pop. Mentalist is 150 pop, 150 to 200. He's 50 pop behind. I'm not sure what the Squires is for. Squires doesn't change the speed of archer movement. Ah, he's actually building a forward castle on the left hand side as well, trying to deny Mentalist of resources of wood. See, wood is definitely important in the main war. Trying to take this hill back. As far as Batsy's he's not focusing down the rams, he's just focusing on the Siege Workshop. Maybe he just isn't looking his gold. Oh no, he is. He did send plumes back to deal with that. He sent more Vills to get gold. He just wants to destroy the forward Siege Workshops, probably just because if he destroys the Siege Workshops, then there will be no more rams for Mentalist. If there's no more rams, I'll be nothing stopping him. There's three rams coming in, those plumes have to be careful. Adding a forward castle, being very, very aggressive. I think Batsy has the advantage. He's got the whole map, he's taking resources, he even wants to add another town centre, he's taking extra stone. He even has 1,000 stone, so we can add another castle when this castle is done. He's got a lot more rams, and we can see Mentalist isn't unlimited wood and gold, but he can't quite defend. Very well played by both. I thought Mentalist had a good chance of taking it earlier when he was pushing the left hand side, I think if he carried on. But he just got outmassed in the end. I don't know, it's hard to tell, I'm not very good at May and Micro, so I'm not sure who Micro'd better. No. You can come Codecast VH. I didn't see your message because I was on playing game status in game, so messages don't pop up. And you're on Do Not Disturb, so I cannot see. More kills for Bacti. More losses for Mentalist. Quite a bit. I think this kind of sums it up for me as well. He did really just get that eco, and he just could afford to spam rounds and plumes forever into those castles, and just having that map control really helped. It's now 3-2 to Bakhti. This is game number 6. I think this is the set game. Yes, this is Desert, Set Civs, Japanese War. Okay. And they're starting. Wait, is it not? What? The score is 2-3. Yeah. Stream must have froze me. What time is it? 18:31. Oh, he sent it 15 minutes ago. So Desert, what was it, Frank War? I said? Oh, Jap War, sorry. Desert Jap War, game 6. Nice. So if Bakhti wins this, he wins. If he loses this, it will go to game number 7, which I think is just a map pack, isn't it? Yeah, map pack, Hidden Civs. That's kind of interesting, because it's like, if you could get any kind of map. Most players pick something like Huns, Aztecs, or Mayans, something they're quite comfortable with, an all-round decent civ. Like, Huns are generally considered strong on water and land, so stuff like that, and because it could be any map. 0.00 delay, thank you, Spec. Would you launch? But yeah, I don't know if you're still in the chat, Fiege, but you can ask Taff. I did ask, but... Do not disturb is powerful. I cannot beat that. Right, so Japanese mentalist. Japanese both, because it's set civ. This is desert. Ah, this is one called desert. It's gonna be quite aggressive, I guess. It's gonna be Menatar, Skirms, Archers, Towers, something like that. I can't imagine them going for the castle war, for I imagine it's going to be a big feudal war into castle. Like, some people can rush FC, but I don't like that on this map. Looking at, like, the gold's all in the middle purposefully, and it's like, their gold's both at the front. It would be really hard for either of these players to rush FC, honestly. I mean, if you get a map that allows it, yeah, like, if you had two wood lines... Left and right, gold in the back, and yeah, obviously you could just rush FC Exposed, but this map's quite open for both of them. I think he's going to trap the villain here or here, probably this one, yeah, and then build a lumber camp behind it. It protects it from early scouts, stuff like that, and rushes. Not so much archers, but by the time archers are there, they will have cut their way out, so it's no problem. It requires a little bit more micro, because the vill, when the lumber camp is built, the vill won't go to a tree to chop. It won't chop any tree, it will just get stuck and stop. I don't know why that happens, but it's guaranteed to happen, so you have to just keep a lookout and click the vill when the lumber camp is done. Someone said it was something about vills not being able to reach a tree they wanted to cut or something like that, I don't really know. So we see a forward... Oh, okay, he's taking his ball, never mind. Finding all of his sheep. It looks like Bakhti is finding his sheep as well. Mentalist in blue, Bakhti in red. So what's happening? 3 on woods, 4 on wood for Mentalist, building his first mill, taking his first boar. Batty's doing the same. He's not added the boy, the ball, the mill yet. He's still only 3 onward. He hasn't added the fourth. I think Mentalist is probably going to rush. He's getting Loom, going to lure the second boar. He'll move the sheep out of the way. Back T will also lure the second boar. This villager is quite risky because of the hills. I don't know if the vill will survive. I think if the first hit is the vill getting hit, you know, getting less damage. Okay. Actually, no, he'll be fine because he's so close to TC that, you know, even they can only take 3 hits so they get the extra damage. Oh, nice. Who's shooting it? Oh, this one. Crikey, I'm surprised it even reached. And he's just going to keep on garrisoning and un-garrisoning until the boar has been eaten, and then he will do it. So, yeah, they both lure them early, but Mentalist, again, is just taking both. Whereas Baptiste is trying to micro... Yeah, he'll just keep on garrisoning and un-garrisoning vills until it's ready. Oh, garrison. Yeah, there we go. I'm not sure. Okay, he's going to build the barracks. Mentalist will also be dropping the barracks soon after this house, I think. I really do think they're both just going to drush. I do not see the extra 10 gold for Mentalist. There it is for Bat T. Maybe Mentalist is going for a flush. Nope, there's the barracks. He's going for a drush. So they're both going to drush. Possibly drush flush. Maybe drush FC. Maybe I was wrong, maybe they just like playing this kind of defensive style, just Drush FC. Just because, you know, you get Castle Age and Expos, it's so strong. It's not like in a team game where if you go full flush as flank, you can kind of survive because the knights from your ally come, and because you have more army, you can sometimes push, but in a 1v1, if you just get outmassed, or if they have too many upgraded units, it's kind of hard. But at the same time, it's a 1v1, so if you go full aggressive against a Drush FC, you can still do really good damage. And like, if you push them back, you can wipe out your opponent. So Mentalist is going to try and wall the front of the map. We see the Drush coming out already for Bat T. This is the same thing as the first game. It didn't work then. I don't know if it's going to work now. Mentalist isn't rushing. He's flushing. Okay. Because he built the early barracks, but he's not made a single militia. So he's just going to wall. Don't tell me he's FCing. That'd be obscene. He's going to get housed though. And then I won't be surprised because he's got housed. He's gonna go for it. He's gonna. Oh, he changed his mind. Oh, 24 pop up. Okay, so he's going archers. It's gonna be flush versus drush. Another lumber camp for back T. He's also going up to field age about the same time. It is gonna be a drush flush, not a drush FC. Maybe he's just gonna. I think he's gonna go home and then he's gonna go forward with men at arms. Because Man at Arms are a nice meat shield, and because he's going up about the same time, if he can drop two lumber camps, I mean, two archery ranges still, like, he can have the same number of archers plus be able to have that good meat shield. It's going to be a forward. Ah, I see. So it was a fast up into Man at Arms forward. I'm going to call it Barl's Star, because Barl's is the first player that really started to do this kind of nonsense. But he used to do it with 22 pop, Mentalist is doing it like 27. So he added a few more vills. It's going to be risky though. He's going to have to be careful. Obviously, Batty has a drush as well, so if he gets his own men at arms, he can defeat the forward. He's actually trying to wall off where he can with houses as well. I think there's a gap between these two. I can't tell. That's why he's grid mud, because I'm a noob. Batty's scouting around. I wonder if he will see it. Forward. Not yet. There's the first archer range. He's going to have archer ranges of his own. So, oh, a fourth militia from Batty. So he can do 4 Menatons versus 3. Adding his own archer range, but building it with 1 vill, not 4. Building a second archery range. So he's building 2 archery ranges of 1 vill each. The Menatons coming forward for Mentalist, but he has to go back because there's more militia for Batty. Japanese units hit faster in Feudal Age. I believe it's Feudal Age that the bonus kicks in. And then when, yep. So obviously, Mentalist is no way going to win this ever. I don't know why he's fighting that. Batsy's got more vills, he had more Menatarms. Actually, there's another Menatarms extra for Mentalist. The thing is, if Batsy defends this, Mentalist is basically dead. He's going to lose 4 forward vills. I think he lost one of them. Two of them's nearly dead. Batsy's adding Skirmish. Actually, it's 1 range versus 2 now, so it was very aggressive, but he didn't scout Bat-T's units. Bat-T added the extra militia, he's got men at arms. He's forced the 4 vills back, none of them have died, but 2 are very nearly dead. Bat-T's got quite a few sick vills as well. Kill the final men at arms. He's gonna wall in the archery range now. Because if he walls in this archery range, yeah, he's gonna kill at least one of these vills, possibly 2. Because now Mentalist has 0 military buildings versus 2 range archers. Now Bat-T can counter forward him, which I think he will. He can build towers on the gold, he can build towers on the wood, he could vill bash down this tower. Like, there's nothing to defend this. If he just sits under the tower with some vills and archers, he can just vill bash it to death. Well, like, towers don't die, but whatever. So he's walled in the archery range, he's going forward himself, he knows he's got this advantage. Yes. They must have paused or something like this.
Yes.
Yep, there was a pause. So they're going back. Okay, so Mentalist is walling the tower now because he knows that, you know, Bat-T can just walk in and kill it. I think Bat-T's going to ignore it. He's going to go straight for the wood line over here, getting fletching as well. So this is really, really bad for Mentalist. I don't know what he's going to do. He's going to have to build more ranges at home or something. He hasn't even got a blacksmith either. There's economy. Where's the tower going for Bat-T? Oh! It's going to hit a lot of farms as well. It's a very aggressive tower. Mentalist trying to add another one at home. Did have vills on stone. Bat-T's going to try and go forward to attack. I think it's been re-walled though. Similar number of vills for both. So yep. Bat-T's been walled out. He's just trying to delay Mentalist tower. They're both going to go up about the same time. They're garrisoned the vills. So Bat-T's just, I think, like, they're both idling the same number of vills, but he's also keeping Mentalist off of his farms, off of the 3 forward farms, even killing a villager, possibly a second. Wow, it's like, it's got presence over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 5, or maybe his first 4 farms, it's not hitting this one. Actually, it hits this one sometimes. And now he's going to bash down the sides. I think Mentalist is trying to think of a recovery plan, which is the... At the moment, it's just going to be defensive towers, and possibly just defensive towers and boom in the back. That looks like what his plan is. Bat-T actually sending the vills out, one by one. Going to... Yep, it's just going to be tower defense from a Mentalist, it looks like. Bat-T adding another tower. Looking at the population, 34 to 50, obviously no army for Mentalist. Adding one archery range, maybe one defense skirms. Because the thing is, he can't go for a full flush. There's just no way he can win with 0 archery ranges versus 2. Losing that forward to the 4 men at arms from Bat-T. It was just smart to add one more. And then just one more. He fought on this hill. He had his vills from his gold. Going to wall in this tower, so he's doing one tower. And he can actually go around the back. It's not fully walled. Mentalist is going to wall it now. 4 vills. Oh, and killed the deer. Okay. I don't know if he was intentionally laming that or if he just attacked it. Double bit axe. I'm not sure what Bat-T's doing with these vills. Oh, he's just going round the sides. Like, he can tower the back of the golden raid. He is housed. Mentalist is pretty scarce on resources. He's 40 population. He's adding more farms at the back. He destroyed the first tower, so I think only this farm is in danger now. Bat-T's going to try and wall, probably tower the back of the wood. Yep, it's going to harass the vills on gold. There is one opening, so they can get in and out freely. The last men at arms went down. Wheelbarrow coming up for Mentalist. He has to play the Castle Age game, really. I think he knows that as well. He just has to try and get to Castle Age as soon as possible, defend with towers and go up and, you know, get expos and mangonels. Because there's 0 chance he can outmass Bat-T. So playing the feudal war, I mean, I guess he could transition into full skirms and scouts, or full archers and scouts, or some kind of really strong combo. But it would be really hard for him, given his resources and the fact that he's been so delayed. And by the time he'd done that, because Bakhti, I don't know, like, if he did that, it could work. Because Bakhti hasn't walled, maybe he assumes Bakhti's walled everything. If he walked in with loads of scouts and archers, he could do a lot of damage. Obviously, if you look at his point of view, he can't really see anything. He knows Bakhti's taking woods here, he knows his goals here, he knows he has ranges there. That's about all he can do, what you can see. And Bakhti's just trying to be a nuisance. Just like, oh, he's actually going to do it. He's going to Vil Bash down the tower. Because there is that opening. Using a scapegoat Vil, which is going to maybe die. Yeah, he's going to lose a couple of archers or something. But he will completely deny Men's List of gold. Like, Men's List will have zero gold. Which is the real problem, I guess. That's why you can't try and play a Castle Age game. Because if he loses all of his gold, then it's going to be in a bad way. Wheelbarrow finished for Bakhti now. Market Blacksmith. I think Mensis will sell stone and, you know, buy his way to Castle Age. Sending out his archers and skirms from his one archery range, but they don't have fletching. And also Bakhti does have a tower there, so they're fighting under a tower. And the tower has a hill bonus. So I don't think this is going to be a good fight for Mentalist. Tower's going to go down. Bills are attacking, but there are some archers there. A lot of skirms though. I don't know if Bakhti... Yeah, Bakhti's going to send his Vils forward as well. Yeah, he tried to push. Like, he felt that he couldn't afford to lose this gold or have it walled in. Getting the plus one defense as well. But look at this, Bakhti's got so much more coming. Because of that double range reduction. Again, he's got two towers on this wood as well to harass all the Vils. I don't know if he's going to wall in the gold or whether he'll tower it, just tower it. Bakhti's going around the left hand side to take out this wall and go around that wood as well. Yep, Bakhti's going up to the Castle Age first as well, just because his eco wasn't harassed. So he could just freely macro at home, and he's going to do a castle drop. You can tell he's got a lot of stone. He'll put a castle on the TC probably. Or maybe this hill, one or the other. The Mentalist will go up to the Castle Age soon. He's obviously going to try the best he can to recover from this. Because if he loses this game, he's going to lose to Bakhti in the showdown, which he doesn't want to do. Defensive tower though, I mean, Mentalist will win this. Towers do not, buildings don't get the attack bonus of height versus other buildings. I think that was intentional, but I'm not sure. It feels like it should be. But obviously Bakhti's just going to give up because he knows it's two towers versus one, and he just wants to push in. So he's just going to build another tower to stop any walling, and it also does put some presence on the wood. I've seen Mentalist does have one Vil outside, but it's one Vil. Maybe he'll just send more out from the TC to try and get gold. Still, his eco's pretty harassed. He's also 5 Vils behind. But he's actually more than 5 Vils behind, because when Bakhti goes up to Castle Age, he'll start adding more Vils, so it's more like 7 or 8 Vils behind. Bakhti's got a lot more army at home as well. Bakhti is up. He's got a lot of resources. Where's that castle? Wait. Oh, he spent all the stone on towers. Okay, no castles for Bakhti. Can build a tower slightly further back. Still try and hit the Vils. Pardon me. Obviously with Balkin, he's got that extra range. Mentalist is trying to go forward and raid with his army, but he doesn't have enough. So, and obviously Bakhti was patrolling. Crossbow coming up for Mentalist, but he's only got one Vil on gold, and he can't sell forever. He's doing a defensive siege workshop. He's going to have some Magnells, an aggressive siege workshop, and university for Bakhti. This is just, it's just so hard to recover from when you lose that initial forward. On a map like this, Like, if Mentis had back gold, it probably wouldn't be so bad. He could just wall defend towers and maybe go off a bit later the same, but the fact that it's such an open map and all the gold is specifically designed to be in the middle of the map, it's really, really hard because you just, when you get on that back foot, to try and push back is just really hard. I probably would have quit as soon as my forward finished and I just realized I had zero gold. You know, something like that. Ballistics coming up for Bat-T. Losing the forward skirms. Well, the thing is, like, it doesn't matter if he kills Mangonels or stuff from Bat-T, he's still behind. It's just that essence of always being behind. I mean, he got crossbow upgrade, but, like, what are you going to do if you've got one range crossbows? And now Bat-T's got enough army, and there's no vills there. He can just walk under the TC. It's not walled here. So Bat-T can still get around. There is that Mangonel he has to be careful of. He could lose a few crossbowmen. But he does have more on the map. He did actually find that mining camp as well. I mean, it was only one vill, so it really doesn't matter that much. Getting Leather Archer armor, probably to defend specifically from Mangonels, I'm guessing. Oh. Losing a lot of expos. He did kill two vills, though. Oh. Yeah, it's just there's so many towers, and the fact they can't get hit, but they can hit the vills, because as soon as the vills get in front of the towers and cut the other trees, these towers will hit them. And yeah, now he's pushing with Mangonels at the front. He's got, still got the crossbowman. He is losing the forward towers to Mentalist crossbowman. But I think if this tower goes down, it's going to be a big problem for Mentalist, then Bat-T. And actually, they do have ballistics as well, remember? So if the vills are attacked. Oh, he did kill the Mangonel. He cannot defend from these four crossbowmen. He's, I don't know what he needs to do, but he has to move the vills away. Mentis is calling the GG. There's just nothing he could do, really. He's just under too much pressure. Both 1TC, Bat-T adding a second TC. Let's check the achievements. Forty-two kills, 25 losses, 5 raises for Mentalist, 5 raises for Bat-T. Though they have 5 buildings raised, 5 buildings lost for Bat-T actually. But not the food difference isn't too much. I think the wood difference and the gold difference are more important in Japanese wars when you're going archers. Food, you know, wasn't that much anyway. I guess it was important. It was more about the timing of the food. He had food later, so. Sorry, I just noticed something interesting in the lobby. Can't be serious. So yeah, that's 4-2 to Bat-T. So, Bat-T wins at best of 7, 4-2. I hope you all enjoyed. That was great fun. I'm gonna see if Rubly Official is still live.